Good morning, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We've been up for a good while now. And guess what? We are just about to enter into a new state that I don't remember ever being since I've had my YouTube channel. And that is West Virginia, ladies and gentlemen. Right as we cross over this river up here, we will be entering West Virginia. Are you guys ready? Here we go. Welcome to West Virginia. Yeah, look at that. Wild and wonderful. All right. Well, what's so wild about West Virginia? I don't know, but this is what they claim up here. Yeah, this is it, guys. Now we are in West Virginia. It's been kind of drizzling on and off all day long here, but yeah, well, that's life. He's 65 mile an hour now. My GPS still says 55. He's gonna speak. Speed warning! Speed warning! Oh well. We saw the sign right there. It says 65. GPS says 55. Oh well, yeah, we're starting to get into some mountains or hills up here, that's for sure. Yep. Oh well, it is an okay morning though. It is fairly humid and hot, but not too shabby. Not too shabby. But yeah, we are going to get to see some beautiful sceneries today, I think. At least I think so. We still have 400 miles to go yet though, to our delivery. I'm gonna give him a call later on and see if I can actually do my trailer switch today. That would be kind of nice if I could do that today. Still haven't gotten no reload yet, so don't know what we're gonna be doing tomorrow yet, but we'll just have to wait and see, I guess. Going to be a waiting game. That's all I can say. But hey, we got our day started now. We started when it was still dark outside. And, well, I didn't really feel like turning on the camera this morning, but sometimes I feel like just taking a break every once in a while too. And I have done that over the past. I sure have. But hey, lately my channel hasn't really been going anywhere. It's just been kind of stuck. I guess you guys aren't sharing my videos anymore. And a lot of you guys have stopped watching too. I've noticed we got less views now. So I don't know what we're doing wrong or what, but hey, if you guys think we need to change something, let me know. If you don't let me know, I don't know what you guys want to see different. And if you have some suggestions or ideas on what you'd like me to improve on or show you more of, we'll try and do that. Yes, indeed. Here we go. Now it's starting to kind of rain again. But yeah. We'll continue on with our journey here today and we'll show you what we can. Here we go. We got us another bridge or river up here. So I figured, gonna go ahead and show you this a little bit. Since this is all new territory for me, I have never ever been on this road as far as I remember. So you guys are coming with me for the first time. Just like I am here the first time. Yeah, as far as I remember anyways. And I seem to be having an issue with my electronic window for the passenger side there. Here on the switch here, like it seems like nothing is going well this trip for me, it seems like. Everything just seems to be falling apart on me. AC ain't working right. Where is is not working at all, better saying. The switch up here, whatever, for some odd reason there earlier, all of a sudden my window was opening and I wasn't even pressing anything. So I tried to close it and it didn't want to close, and so finally I got it to close. And then as soon as I did that, as soon as I let go of the button, it reopened again. I'm like, what the heck? You know, somewhere a malfunction or whatever you want to call it, but yeah. I'm not sure in which town we're in, but we're in some kind of city.
For 60 miles.
That's for sure. Well, it looks like right lane closed, so I guess I'll move into this lane up here. Yeah, I have no idea what this is for a city, but doesn't really matter. It's still raining up here, and we're just cruising right on through here. Looks like we got a smoke bay up here, watching the construction zone. Ramp is closed, so that's good. Well, I don't know if it's good, but whatever. Nobody can get into that town, I guess. We don't want people coming in. Yeah, probably can take another exit somewhere else, but yeah, it is not bad scenery up here. The only problem is it's raining, which I suspect that it will be doing because there's that tropical storm coming through here that came through from Florida, right? Of course, no single light, you just move over like really, like that close in front of me, eh? There you go, okay. Some drivers, eh? That's why it's important to have a dash cam these days, you know? You gotta watch these four-wheelers sometimes. Yeah, look like that's coming down hard now, eh? Wow. That's what it looks like. Which it has been doing here for a good while, right? So, alright, I guess this right lane must exit, so I guess we better move back into this lane then. Well, looks like we're going right alongside of that river. That river is just behind the buildings up there. Yeah, I'm trying to keep my window open a little bit so that way you guys can, might be able to hear me okay, but you might also be able to hear a little bit of a wind noise or whatever, but I gotta stay comfortable in here too, right?
Hey, this tune is dedicated to all the great truck driving songs and singers of the past. I just crossed Fraser Creek at 1 o'clock today. No one riding with me, so there wasn't much to say. I looked into that west coast mirror and saw a nice rainbow. And by the way, here comes three big semis in a row. That girl I left in Little Rock left me with a smile. So I grabbed my breath mints off the dash and I thought of her a while. The last thing that she said to me was, Theodore, go slow. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. I wonder if this Peterbilt could talk, what would it say? Would it tell me about the sights it's seen across the USA? Hey, I hear Stone Cold Fingers playing on the radio. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. I hope I can gear this old truck down, 'cause there's a cop. Though I could have used a little more speed to get me to the top of Mont Eagle, where a few have died and left us feeling low. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. beating through the windshield, melting my dentine. So I pulled down the sun visor and it fell between my knees. A picture of that truck stop waitress we all knew was Flo. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. Someone on the CB is cussing them orange cones, and the brake check up ahead is making my tires moan. I see that flag man holding up a sign and it reads slow. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. Will they ever finish Highway 59? I sure don't know. And by the way, here comes three more semis in a row. Man, I can't believe this construction. We're in a heck's at fifth gear. It's here somewhere. Man, I gotta get back to Little Rock. I wonder whatever happened to old Flo.
Alrighty, guys, we stopped here at the Flying J. Yeah, as you can see, there's plenty of parking up here. I mean, it is lunchtime right now, right? But yeah, I saw something cool up there in a fuel island. And so I'm gonna go down there and I'm gonna go talk to the guy and see if I can get that on video. I saw some really nice old type of police car up there, so let's go down there and see if we can go ahead and look at that. I would love to show you guys. It would be kind of nice. Yeah, this is the fuel island over here. So we're gonna go down here and see if we can see what I saw here coming in here. So I don't know if they're still here or not, but we'll go check it out anyways. Yeah, they're here. Looks like he's right there with the camper. Let's go talk to them, see if I can talk to him, see if we can show the car. Yeah. Hey man, how's it going? Yeah, you mind if I videotape your police car a little bit?
Absolutely. Go ahead.
What's your name?
I'm Sam.
Sam? Yeah. I'm Trucker Rudy. I'm a YouTuber.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I make YouTube videos, so I figured, you know what? Let's show my viewers what kind of car we got up here, you know?
Appreciate that. Thank you so much.
I'll give you a card here if I can just get it out of my wallet.
Okay.
And you can check me out.
I will definitely do that.
Yeah. I'm usually 7 days behind.
Okay.
So in about 7 days you'll see that video.
I will look for it. Thank you so much.
Yeah, so let's go show the viewers what we came to see here.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's go have a look. Hey. You got some nice dogs there, eh?
Oh,
are they friendly?
Yes, they are.
Ah, very, yeah. I got a friend, Trucker Jukebox, he's got a few dogs too, and very, very nice dogs, you know.
They're so used to traveling.
Oh, yeah.
Strangers, so.
Where are you guys heading?
Pardon me?
Where are you guys heading?
We're heading down to, Lake Norman, and then we're heading back up to Mount Airy.
Oh, nice.
They've got Andy Griffith days going on next weekend.
Ah, there you go.
So it's going to be in the parade.
Oh, nice. Yeah, let's go check it out. Is there any story behind the car?
Well, it's an Andy Griffith squad car.
Okay.
I don't know if you've heard of Andy Griffith or not.
No, I'm from South America originally, but I live in Canada now.
Okay.
So. Oh, really? Nice. Is this the original?
My husband redid it.
Ah, there you go. Cool. All right, let's have a look at this bad boy. Wow, look at that. One bullet. That's what it says, I think. They're from, they're from Ohio. Yeah, look at this. This is the steel whip that Jukebox always talks about that the old cops cars had. It's a 102-inch steel whip. It's an actual police car, guys. Let's take a look inside. We're not gonna touch it. It's got 120 mile an hour speed limit there on the speedometer. Wow, that's an awesome looking car there. Wow. Yeah, I love old classic cars myself, so I hope you guys don't mind me showing that. So
Hey, let's go in and get a shower done.
Alrighty, guys, let's get out of here. We've had ourselves a shower, had a bite to eat, all of that good stuff. Opened my window a little bit so some fresh air can come in here. Got all our business taken care of. So now it's time to get out of here. Some of you might say, well, he's still wearing the same YouTube shirt than he was before, right? Well, that's because I do have two YouTube shirts, so I put a clean one on. It's a different one than what I was wearing before. Yes, indeed. It's a little weird on how we have to get into this Flying J and get out of here, so I figured, gotta show you this anyways. We're kind of like on the top of the hill here, and I kind of gotta go down like that and then make my turn to go back onto the interstate. So yeah, a little different than what I'm used to or whatever.
In 600 feet, turn right on Rally Mix Road.
We'll go ahead and show you this.
Take the entrance to the right in 100 feet.
It's a really steep, whatever, incline here or decline or whatever you want to call it, and then you can't really see if anybody's coming from there. You gotta kind of look in the mirror, make sure nobody's coming, so that way we can get back on the road, right? Yeah, it is a little weird, but whatever, we gotta deal with it, right? We're truckers, we're professional drivers, we can handle it, right? I think so anyways. Another stop sign here. There we go. Let's get back on the interstate and then get the rest of the miles in. I called the customer while I was sitting in there just before I left and asked them if I can drop my trailer there today, and they said yes, you sure can. So I'm gonna go ahead and try and do that today yet, because I haven't gotten no reload yet and I don't really feel like getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning and go deliver this load at 6 o'clock and then just to come back to the truck stop and wait for a reload, you know. But anyways, let's make her down there and we'll take care of business, right? Ladies and gentlemen, here we are going downhill. We were all the way on the top there and GPS told me we will be in North Carolina here in a few minutes. Look right here to the left. It's not as high as we were, but it is still pretty steep. And we are still rolling downhill. We got to use our engine brake pretty heavily now. But hey, we got Bozo on the phone here, and he's trying to distract me, but he's not really working. But whatever, let him talk in the background there as much as he wants. I don't really care. But yeah, it's absolutely beautiful up down here, you know? Beautiful mountains and beautiful scenery. I love it. They got like a runaway lane right there going straight up of that hill there. You'll see it here in a second, guys. Oh yeah, CRL England is ahead of us here, so he's stepping on his brakes, so we're gonna slow her down too, right? Right there, you see that runaway lane up there? Yeah, we don't want to go up there, that's for sure, but yeah, absolutely nice and green down here. I don't even really see any yellow leaves yet like we see further north, like everything is turning into winter, but no, up here it's absolutely beautiful. And a couple of miles here we'll be in North Carolina, and GPS just screamed the way station ahead. But hey, I don't really care. They're gonna pull Bozo in, not me, right? But yeah, anyways, says 2 miles to the rest area. Alright, welcome center to North Carolina. Well, looks like they got a big love right there across the line. But yeah. Hey, got digital signs up here now, guys. Look at that. We got LED signs up there for what the speed limit is, so that's kind of cool. But anyways, we'll get out of here, guys. We'll talk with you all a little bit later. We'll get back to talking to Bozo. I am on the last stretch of getting to my delivery. Only 14 more miles, ladies and gentlemen. That's right. Yeah. And believe it or not, I just got me a reload offer. I couldn't believe it. It's only 88 miles from my delivery to my pickup, which is not even that bad. I can actually make it all the way back there today if I want and go down to my pickup. But the only problem is that only picks up tomorrow at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, which that kind of sucks a little bit, but hey, that's all right. We'll give us some time to work on the videos, take a little bit of a break and all that good stuff. And we'll go down there and pick it up tomorrow afternoon, I guess. But that load is actually going to Toronto or Brampton, Ontario. Well, it's not going home, but at least it's going back north, which we knew it had to. But yeah, I'm very surprised that I got a reload today. But anyways, we're going to go make our delivery here, and then hopefully they have an empty trailer there for me so I can just pick up an empty and get out of there. I have just done my trailer switch, ladies and gentlemen. And lo and behold, we got us a little bit of a shower. Yeah, not myself. I'm referring to a little bit of rain. Rain showers. Yeah. That's fantastic. That's going to cool everything down a little bit. That is fantastic news. And I'm kind of debating on whether or not I should go take this exit right here. It looks like there's a truck coming off of there, so I might consider taking that route as well. Let's go out and see if there's any signs there for no trucks there, but I don't think there is, because I see a truck coming down here, so yeah, I don't see no truck sign here, so yeah, this is actually a little bit closer if I go down here, and plus I'm empty anyway, so may as well go down here and give that a try, right? So let's go down here and let's get back onto our main highway, and then let's head towards our pickup place. It's only about 92 miles, I think the GPS said. I thought it said 88 earlier, but now difference of 3 miles, right? No big deal. That's right.
Construction ahead.
Still drizzling a little bit, but I don't care as long as it's cooling off, right? I did take a little bit of time out there and let my EQ unit cool a little bit, so that way it cooled down my cab at least a little bit. So here we go. Oh, come on. Let's gear her down a little bit. Let's go. Yeah. So let's make our way down to our pickup. And we'll wait there till tomorrow. We are still cruising. And we are in the back roads, as you guys can obviously see. And I thought, you know what? It's a beautiful town up here with big trees, old trees, all that good stuff. So I figured I'd turn on my camera for a little bit. Show you a little bit. Yeah. Just as much as I was trying to show you, now it's already over. Just about anyways. So I mean, there is good little towns here every once in a while. So you got their little school up here, all that good stuff. So might be a few more towns or a few more beautiful homes up here before we know. There is a nice one right there to the right. I like that. All built out of bricks. I like that. But some of them old classic type of buildings, I really enjoy that, you know. Beautiful trees around the house, you know, around the properties. And just absolutely gorgeous in my opinion. Look at that right there. I mean, that's an old classic house right there. Man, just absolutely gorgeous. I would love to live out here. Look at this, eh? Man, nice little piece of property, you know. In a beautiful bush surrounding areas. Oh man, that's so gorgeous. But we gotta continue on with our cruising here. our way down back to the interstate, I guess. Here we go. That's right. Now I guess we're through the town because we got higher speed limits.
I am very happy that I've been pushing very hard the first 2 days, guys. Yes, indeed I am. And the reason why I am, because I went down to my delivery, got my trailer switch, and just before we got there, as you guys heard me say, we got us a reload, right? So what that allowed me to do is get within 13 miles of my pickup. And as you can see, it started to rain. Yeah, so that is actually nice for me because that means it's cooling down, right? So, right now I don't have to drive any further, but that meant for the last little bit here, it started to cool down, and that was kind of nice. It actually started raining right over there when I just finished doing my trailer switch, and then it quit for a little while there, and then just before I got here, it started raining again. So it's kind of nice, actually. But yeah, we are done for today. We can only pick up the load tomorrow at 1 o'clock, so we're probably going to sleep in and work on our videos a little bit and all that good stuff. So we appreciate you guys sticking around, even with my complaining all day long here about the AC and all that. And it did get pretty warm out here. At one point, I saw 32 Celsius on my gauge there on the truck, so it did get pretty warm. But anyways, we'll catch you right here tomorrow. Have a good one, everybody. Don't forget to give a good thumbs up, share the video, and if you're new to our channel, would love to have you hit that subscribe button down there below. Yeah, and read some of the links that I have down in my description box as well. That's very important too. And we are uploading videos daily, so don't go nowhere.
It's time to get going. It's time to move on. Put this behind me. That day is gonna come.